Hi guys, Mel here. I want to show you what I eat when I have a busy day but still need to stick to my macros. Now, we normally do keto recipes on this channel, and if you're after that sort of thing, we've got tons. And if you're new here, do subscribe, hit the bell so you can view my next wonderful creation. Jokes. And if you're already subscribed, thank you so much. Love ya. So originally I was asked to create a New England clam chowder that is keto friendly. And you guys know New England clam chowder has potatoes in it. But the other thing is, I don't like cauliflower as a substitute for this or for that. If I want to have cauliflower, it must just be a cauliflower dish. This now led me to explore using kohlrabi as a potato substitute. However, kohlrabi is slightly higher in carbs. I also looked for the best New England clam chowder recipe I could find to convert to keto, and I found one amazing one actually by Natasha's Kitchen. She has her own website and she's a huge channel here on YouTube, and I'm gonna leave the link to the original recipe for you in the description box. Anyway, I did create this great recipe, but it is higher in carbs, and I want to show you what I ate in the day to fit it all into my macros, and I am on a 1600 calorie limit. Now, with my dinner being higher in carbs, aka the clam chowder, I had to be super strict during the day and minimize my breakfast and lunch down to a very minimal carb count. So you're gonna get a 2-for-1 deal. You're gonna get what I eat in a day, and you're gonna get the clam chowder recipe. Do stick around, because towards the end of the video, we're gonna give you the macros for the meals I've had today. Let's get into it. So starting off with some breakfast, I'm having a keto oatmeal, and I meal prep these into bags, and that's what you're seeing here. I just pour my powders into a bowl, and I add 180 ml of unsweetened almond milk, and then I sometimes have it with sugar-free chocolate, and here I've got some honeycomb essence. And if you want the link to this recipe, click on the link to the top right-hand corner now, and that's the keto oatmeal. For my burger, I added 100 grams of ground beef to a bowl and one egg. And then I seasoned that with a pinch of pepper, a pinch of salt, a pinch of paprika and garlic powder, and combined it. Please don't judge me, it doesn't look that great, but remember, this is what I'm doing to hit my nutrition goals. Then over medium heat, I fried it on both sides until the patty was cooked. And to make my burger, I used lettuce as a bun. And then to the patty, I added 30 grams of mozzarella, then 30 grams of sliced tomato, and spread 10 grams of mayonnaise on top, and another piece of lettuce, and that was it. I'm doing all the prep work first, so I diced 100 grams of bacon, and it equates to about 6 slices. And then I sliced 1/3 cup of carrots, finely diced 1/3 cup of celery, and 1/3 cup of onion, and set that aside. If you haven't seen kohlrabi before, this is what it looks like. And when it's raw, it smells like leek to me, and it looks like a green turnip or beetroot. But the amazing thing is that it tastes like sweet potato when it's cooked. Anyway, I used 300 grams of kohlrabi for this clam chowder and prepared it by peeling it first. Then there's a portion of the flesh that's quite hard, so I removed that too and cut it into about 1/2 inch size pieces and placed it in water until I was ready to add it. Then, using a medium-sized pot and over a medium heat as well, I fried the bacon until brown, removed it from the pot and left the excess oil in the pot, but it still looks a little dry to me, so I added a teaspoon of olive oil. I then added all three veggies at once and sauteed them until soft, and that took me about 5 minutes. Next, I added 2 cups of chicken stock, 1 bay leaf, 1/2 teaspoon of Tobasco sauce, 1.5 teaspoons of Worcestershire sauce, half a teaspoon of dried thyme, 1 teaspoon of black pepper, and 184 grams worth of the shredded clams and the juice. Over a medium to high heat, bring the chowder to a boil, then add the 300 grams of kohlrabi pieces and let it cook on high for 10 minutes so it can soften. Then turn the heat back down to medium and add 1 cup of heavy cream. Let the chowder simmer on medium for another 20 minutes, and if you find that the sauce isn't thick enough, you can always mash a few kohlrabi and stir it in. I didn't want to use any almond flour or xanthan gum in this recipe, but you may want to if you want to use that as a thickener. After a few minutes, give it a taste and check if it needs salt and also that the kohlrabi is soft. Turn off the heat now, and when you're ready to serve, add the bacon pieces to the chowder and a sprinkle of cilantro. I know cilantro is not a normal ingredient in chowder, but this will give you an extra wow factor. And of course, do remove the bay leaf. This is one of my very favorite keto breads. Link is in the top right-hand corner. To me, a chowder is served in a round bread bowl. So I cut out the middle, and guys, just check out how beautiful this bread is. And I had 2 slices with my chowder, and this chowder will serve 4. So that is my macros for the day, using 300 grams of kohlrabi and then saving my carbs for my dinner. And I hope you can see what you can do if you have to store your carbs for one meal. It's very handy if you have to go out or you have to eat at a friend's place. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and be well.